the frequency of motor neuron stimulation. A single action potential from a motor neuron will produce a single contraction in muscle fibers of its motor unit. This isolated contraction is called a twitch. The tension produced by a single twitch can be measured by a Maia Graham, which is an instrument that measures the amount of tension produced over time. Each twitch undergoes three phases: a latent period, a contraction phase, and a relaxation phase. During the latent period, the action potential is being propagated along the sarcolemma and calcium ions are released from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. However, contraction has not yet occurred. In the contraction phase, calcium ions in the sarcoplasm have bound to troponin, tropomyosin has shifted away from actin binding sites, and crossbridges have formed. Here, the sarcomeres are actively shortening to the point of peak tension. In the relaxation phase, tension decreases as contraction stops. Calcium ions are pumped out of the sarcoplasm back into the sarcoplasmic reticulum, and crossbridge cycling stops. This returns the muscle fiber to its resting state. Although a person can experience a muscle twitch, a single twitch does not produce any significant muscle activity in a living body. A series of action potentials to the muscle fibers is necessary to produce a muscle contraction that can produce work. Normal muscle contraction is more sustained, and it can be modified by input from the nervous system to produce varying amounts of force. This is called a graded muscle response. The frequency of action potentials or nerve impulses from a motor neuron, as well as the number of motor neurons transmitting action potentials, both affect the tension produced in skeletal muscle. If the fibers are stimulated while a previous twitch is still occurring, the second twitch will be stronger. This response is called wave summation. Wave summation occurs because the excitation-contraction coupling effects of successive motor neuron signaling is summed or added together. At the molecular level, summation occurs because the second stimulus triggers the release of more calcium ions, which become available to activate additional sarcomeres while the muscle is still contracting from the first stimuli. Summation results in greater contraction of the motor unit. If the frequency of motor neuron signaling increases, summation and subsequent muscle tension in the motor unit continues to rise until it reaches a peak point. The tension at this point is about 3 to 4 times greater than the tension of a single twitch. This state is referred to as incomplete tetanus. During incomplete tetanus, the muscle goes through quick cycles of contraction with a short relaxation phase for each. If the stimulus frequency is so high that the relaxation phase disappears completely, the contractions become continuous in a process called complete tetanus. During complete tetanus, the concentration of calcium ions in the sarcoplasm allows virtually all of the sarcomeres to form crossbridges and to shorten. This allows the contraction to continue uninterrupted. Tetanus is the fusion of contractions to produce a continuous contraction.